Hi guys, James at Rampant Lion Reviews again for you today with another beer review. For this one, we are going to stick to Sweden and we're going to head up towards Gothenburg once again, or Göteborg as you would say in Swedish. And we're going to have a look at a beer that is a collaboration between two different breweries, one of whom is one of my favourite Swedish craft breweries. Pretty much anything those guys do turns to gold these days. And then another brewery who are kind of an amalgamation of two breweries that have got good reputations. So for this review, we are going to return to Brewery once again, and we're having a taste of the Tutti Frutti, which is a 6% sour ale. So this one is based on the Tutti Frutti sweets that you can buy in all the supermarkets here. It's a fruit sour beer, this one, and it's a collaboration with Wizard Brewing, who are they're sort of a collaboration or an amalgamation, if you like, of Moron Dogans and Microphone Bigeriet. So really should be an interesting beer, this one. I'm really curious to see how this turns out. But anyway, as is usual with my reviews, then I'll tell you a little bit about both the breweries involved here. If you want to get straight to the tasting, just fast forward. All the usual links are in the description below. That's the brewery websites, the link to my other reviews that I've done, both from Dugas Brewery and from Wizard Brewing. Very first thing, I think I'm trying something from Wizard Brewing, of course. There's all the usual social media. If you want to see more beer reviews, do please consider subscribing to the channel. The whole channel, of course, has a geography-based tagging system, so you can go into the homepage and search for beer based on country, city, state, county, prefecture, whatever it is you're interested in. Do check out the playlists of beers from different countries. There is one there for all the Swedish beers that I've reviewed for you. That's constantly being added to, and as always, please do get in touch and let me know some of the other beers and breweries that you guys would like to see me review. It's always great to hear from you guys that are watching the videos, and the support that you show the channel is hugely appreciated. So anyway, to tell you a little bit about Dugas Brewery first off then, since they are the kind of home brewery. So Dugas Brewery, as I've told you before, are based in Landvetter on the outskirts of Gothenburg. I think they're out to the east, the kind of northeast-ish somewhere. But the brewery was established back in 2005 in Mölndal by Mikael Engström Dugge, and since 2010 it's focused solely on the production of top fermented beers. But due to the kind of boom that there's been in Swedish craft brewing in recent years, the brewery very, very quickly outgrew the original brewery, and so they had to move from Mölndal up to Landvetter, which is of course very close to Gothenburg's airport. But the older brewery had a capacity of around 1500 hectolitres of beer per year, but their new brewery started off with a capacity of 8,000 hectolitres, and recently they've been investing heavily in their barrel aging program as well. For me, this brewery, they've got things from lots of different styles that are very good. I mean, I'm sure I've had a quadruple from these guys, which I really quite enjoy, the Boom Barrel. Either that or that was a barley wine. So they're very good at quads, they're very good at barley wines. Some of their Imperial Stouts are awesome. They're one of the best coffee stout producers in the world, in my opinion. I've had some awesome, awesome coffee stouts from those guys. Some of the IPAs that they've had, like the Crush and the Fresh recently, have also been very good. And of course, you've got some of these fruit sour beers that are also really, really pretty damn good as well. And they're also one of the most widely exported Swedish craft breweries as well. I know they're exporting to the States and to Australia and New Zealand and stuff like that. I think they might actually also be in Japan too, and I did see a couple of their beers in Hong Kong, if memory is serving me correctly. So definitely one of the Swedish breweries that you want to have a go of if you are particularly interested in Swedish craft beer. But yeah, to tell you a little bit about Wizard Brewing then, if you want to learn more about Dugas, check out the brewery websites and stuff in the description below, and you can follow them on Facebook and Instagram and stuff like that, and that'll keep you up to date with all the latest goings on. But yeah, on to Wizard Brewing then. This is the brewery who are new to me. So Wizard Brewing, as I told you earlier, are based in the Gothenburg area, and the company was started as a new brand by Nicholas Sarsevich, who is from Microphone Bigeriet. He also plays in the band Melancholin, and you've also got Jonas Gustafsson there as well from Morgan Dogans Brewery. But apparently they first met at All In Beer Festival back in 2017, and they became good friends and spent a lot of time over the next year kind of hanging out together and things like that. But they collaborated together and released a beer that was called Send In The Clowns between the actual two breweries. But then they decided they wanted to make a fully joint venture, and this officially began in January of 2019, and they say that they want to brew around 80,000 litres of beer in the first year. But the brewery itself is based in Kungsten, and they've invested heavily in the fermentation tanks there to get their capacity up. But they also hope to be able to open a pub at the brewery very, very soon. And so at this brewery in Kungsten, that's where all three brands of beer are brewed: the Microphone Bigeriet beers, the Wizard Brewing beers, and also the Moron Dogans ones as well. But the artwork on the cans that they usually have is designed by Alexander Jansson, if I remember the name correctly, and they actually had a little bit of a problem with one of their beers, because the can's artwork is basically fantasy based, and Sustainable Lager were saying that it was the part of the Sustainable Lager laws is that the beers can't appeal to children, so there was a bit of a problem with the fantasy artwork and things like that. But some of the beers passed the controls and some of them didn't, so there wasn't really a kind of consistent approach, so they had to pay a lot of money to get the artwork on some of their beers changed, which is a bit of a shame for them. But supposedly a very, very good brewery actually, so I'll need to try some of their beers at some point soon after this review too. But yeah, that's all you really need to know about Wizard Brewing for the moment. We've got two very good Gothenburg breweries here. And there's the Gothenburg beer scene, there's so much stuff going on there, it's actually quite difficult to keep up to date with all the different things that are happening there. But yeah, that's all you need to know about both breweries involved there. If you want to learn more, again, you can check out Wizard Brewing's Facebook page and Instagram and stuff like that. That'll keep you up to date with all the latest goings on. And of course, you can check out both breweries' Untappd pages for the lists of all the different beers that they have. But yeah, let's get on and actually taste this beer then. I'll just have a little look at the artwork of this one before we open up. There you can see, typical Dugas artwork. I don't know what it is, but pretty much every Dugas beer that I ever find at Sustainable Lager, it always has a little tear down the label here. I think they maybe need to use slightly more durable labels or something like that. But it says on the side here, how many fruits do you need for it to be tutti frutti? Together with Wizard, we decided to go for all of them, almost. Pear, mango, passion fruit, peach, pineapple and mandarin. That's right, tutti frutti. So yeah, lots of fruits basically added to this one. Plain bottle cap on this one, as you always get from Dugas Brewery. But let's get it out and we'll get on with the tasting then. Yeah. So, as you can see with this beer, that looks really nice actually. As you can see with this one, it's poured a sort of murky colour. It's actually kind of, it's almost like a mixture of the two colours that are on the label there. But as you can see with this one, it's poured that lovely kind of murky, it's almost like a sandy kind of colour, this one. That's quite interesting. You can smell some of these lovely fruity notes just coming out of the beer as you put it into the glass. But yeah, lovely kind of murky orangey colour, this one. You could see there was a thin layer of a frothy, I would say just kind of creamy, white head on this. One or two big bubbles sticking towards the side of the glass and a few little ones just heading up towards the bottom of that head there. But overall, it does actually look pretty damn nice, I have to say. But yeah, nothing, not out with the realms of possibility for what you would expect from a fruit sour beer, especially when it's got all of these different things in it. So yeah, let's take a closer look at the aroma then and just see how we get on. Oh, that smells ridiculous. That's really good. It's really juicy. I mean, it literally does just smell like... it literally does smell just like a bag of the Tutti Fruities. So, yeah, I can see the I can see why they've done the name of this one. Straight away, you're going to recognise that. I should have got a bag of Tutti Fruities and actually done the video with them in it. But yeah, that's really nice actually. I really like the aroma of this beer. Yeah, so could sit and smell that all day. I don't even know where to start with this one. It really just smells like a whole amalgamation of things. For me, I think the pears are quite obvious in this one. The oranges are there too. You can smell a bit of everything. I think it's the peaches and the pears. The sharpness of the peaches is really jumping out. The juiciness of the oranges is there. The sort of lightness and kind of fluffiness, light wispiness, I don't even know how you would describe that, but the pears to me are coming out as quite obvious. The passion fruit, not so much actually, maybe more in the background. But I mean, this beer really just smells like a big mishmash of fruit. The juicy oranges are there, a little bit of the lighter peary notes, the mangoes, stuff like that. It's got a little bit of everything, this one, so I really like how the whole aroma of this beer is going together. I mean, that's definitely it's definitely worth just taking a bit of time and enjoying that aroma. I mean, other than the fruits, there's maybe a little touch of grassiness, a little bit of a slightly hoppy grassiness or something there, and you can smell that there's a little bit of a kind of bready, biscuity base to it. But really, this is just, it really smells just like a bag of sweets, to be quite honest with you. You can't really say much more about the aroma than that. Yeah, lovely. So without further ado then, let's have a taste of this one. So this one is the Tutti Frutti, a 6% sour ale from Dugas Brewery and Wizard Brewing, both from Gothenburg here in Sweden. Let's get stuck into this one. Slange, skål. Oh, tell you something, that's a really bloody good beer. It has a good bit of sharpness on it in the beginning, but then you just get this wash of juicy fruity quality after it. And it really is just very nice how that goes together. Yeah. I really, really like how that beer goes together. That's really good. You know, big thumbs up to Dugas Brewery once again. And you know, from what I've heard about Wizard Brewery, they're meant to be pretty good at their sour beers as well. I know, I've tried Microphone Brewery before, but I've not tried Marlon Doggins at all. So I need to look into them a little bit at some point. But yeah, Microphone Brewery, they've got a really good reputation, and you know, and they're only going to learn more from going up to Dugas Brewery as well. But that's really, really nice. I mean, I think the actual base of the beer is pretty kind of straightforward. I mean, the middle of your palate really is. It's just a sort of pale, malty, slightly wheaty, white, bready quality. That just blankets the middle of your tongue. And then the centre of your palate, you've also got a little touch of a biscuity quality in there too. Yeah, I do like how everything is going together in this one. It's it really is quite well done, I have to say. So yeah, the fruity side of this beer is quite interesting too. I mean, hoppy side of the beer, I think there's a little touch of earthiness in the back corners of the palate. And as you come kind of further forward along the sides of the tongue, I think you've got, you know, it is a little bit kind of floral and grassy. There is a little bit of a sort of floral quality there. And then around the very front curve of the palate, you do get a little touch of grassiness in there. I think maybe they've put a little bit of, it could be like Hallertau-Tintnang, or maybe a little bit of Sats or something like that in here. So yeah, a little bit of noble hoppy quality. And then behind the front curve of the palate, you've got a little bit of that sharper, almost lemony tartness that you would expect from, you know, Lactobacillus or Brettanomyces, whichever one it is they're actually using in here. But when you add fruit into a beer, the juiciness of the fruit is always going to come out around the edge of the tongue, and it suppresses some of the IBUs a little bit, and you can really detect that with this beer. The further you go into the aftertaste, for me, it's the peary notes that are kind of lingering there, and perhaps a little bit of the mango, to be honest with you as well. Further and earlier on in the taste, I think that's when you start to get a bit of the darker passion fruit. There's a little bit of the darker passion fruit in the beginning, and the mangoes linger into the aftertaste. The pears do as well. For me, the orangey flavour, it was really, the orange was really obvious in the aroma, but it's not so obvious in the flavour in my mind. I'm starting to get some of the pineapple out now. The pineapple's almost on the kind of tip of your tongue a little bit, then the mangoes is just a little bit further around, and then the pears just kind of infused into all of that. I'm not noticing orangey flavours all that much in this one. But yeah, the passion fruit kind of comes in the beginning and then fades away a little bit. It does kind of sit there behind the front of the tongue right enough. This is quite a difficult beer to describe because it's got so many different fruits in it. I'm just trying to remember exactly how many are in this one. So, pears, mangoes, passion fruit, peach, pineapple and mandarin. You know, in fairness, I was forgetting the peach was in there. The peach might be, I always remember peach being very sharp. I don't really eat peach all that often, to be honest. But you know, I think you might get a bit of the peach, now that I think about it, I think you might be getting a bit of the peaches mixing in with that kind of sharpie, the sharp lemony quality that I was describing. Yeah, the peachy notes are just coming out. If you go, it's just behind the front of the tongue with some of the sharper notes, which is obviously from the type of wild yeast that they're using in here. So yeah, you'll get the peachy notes earlier on in that. That was just something I hadn't thought of actually, which was kind of interesting. But Yeah, the way all of that goes together is really quite good, and it is just a whole kind of mishmash of different things. So just be aware of that when you try this beer. This is definitely one of the more difficult ones to describe that I've had recently. So this probably isn't my best review video that I'm doing for you, because it's just basically this whole thing is just a mishmash of different fruit flavors and stuff. But it works really well, this one actually. I certainly wouldn't hesitate to drink that beer again, and I'm sure on tap when it's got a slightly thicker mouthfeel and malty base to it. I think that would be a very, very interesting beer. So let's leave it at that for the flavour side of things. In terms of the mouthfeel, this is a fairly mid-bodied beer. It's actually quite a bit thicker compared to some of the other sour beers that I've had. But yeah, mid-bodied, carbonation's very smooth. It does have a bit of an oily quality to it, but quite a thick, wet mouthfeel, this one. Little touch of smoothness and sweetness to the malt base, and you know, very lucky to get many IBUs out of this. I think you're talking about 10. There is just a little bit of a slightly noble-ish hoppy quality to this one, but there may not be any hops in it at all, to be honest. But yeah, nice little bit of sharp tartness from the wild yeast that they're using here, and a lot of juicy fruitiness as well. But yeah, an interesting beer this one. Definitely very close to the Tutti Frutti Sweets, so you can see why they'll have named it this. And you know, they've probably used those flavours. I don't know whether they would have made this beer like that, or they would have. It sounds like what they've done is they've actually, you know, looked at what kind of flavour sweets you get and then used that to make the beer rather than the other way around. But you know, it's. I'm talking rubbish now. It's a really nice beer, this one, and I like how it goes together. Let's just leave it at that. Very, you know, it's just quite funny to see a beer made in the image of sweets that I really quite like. This is a bad review, this one. But we'll leave it at that just now. But basically, I really like this beer. Definitely one of the harder ones to that I've found to describe for you over the last little while. So just, if you get the chance, have a go at it for yourself and see what you think, and you know, try some of the other sour beers that these guys do as well. But yeah, once again, thank you for watching my beer reviews. As always, please like, subscribe, share, all the usual YouTube stuff. Let me know your own thoughts on this beer in the comment section below. Let me know what your favourite beers are from Dugas and from Wizard as well. I hope you've enjoyed my kind of rather uninformative take on this one, I guess I would say this time. But I hope you've enjoyed it, and thank you again for watching. Until the next time, Slange and Snout, and I'll catch you guys later. The Tutti Frutti, a 6% fruit sour beer from Dugas Brewery in collaboration with Wizard Brewing, both of whom come to you from Gothenburg. Until the next time, Slange and Snout, and I'll catch you guys later. Slange, skål.